Who man a cussing man a kick up rum post? But you me no star. What a disgrace when two gyal a trace. A peer bad word them a cussing at the place. A pint them and in a one another face. And I tell each other say fi hold them space. Here one of them no kiss me man shoes lace. Here the next one yam out me glass case. When two gyal a cuss, a peer mix up you get fi know who a dog. From who a slut, who a suck, who from who a get. Who for man have money, from who for pocket broke. Who a bring belly, from who a dash a gut. Who a get jacket and a wear waistcoat. Mavis and Precious, you know them catch up in a the big tenement yard, don't a poor us. Them a bark, them a bite, them a fight, them a fuss, them a wiggle, them a turn, them a joke. What's up, New York? This is James Bond, 007. Yeah? Floyd Brown from Spanish Town, Jamaica. Live and direct. Hear that? I was born in Spanish Town, 4 Waterloo Lane. The gully side, when we talk about gully side, we are talking about the original gully side, yeah? Went to St. Catherine Prep, then St. Catherine Primary, then from there I went to St. John's Primary, and then to Spanish Town High School, formerly Spanish Town Secondary. Back home in Jamaica, I used to love football, was my thing. And track and field. Oh gosh, man. You know, I used to play every sports. Football, track and field, cricket, you know, and table tennis was some of my main sports that I used to play. You know, and as a matter of fact, I was very good. And up till this day, I still play soccer. I run left my brother them when they come near me sometime. And I just run left the wall of them and show them, say, me the boss, hear that. I used to go to school, of course, Lieutenant Stitchy was one of my schoolmates. You know, Cleveland. Santa, big up yourself, hear that. Captain Barkey, you know, was another one. Jonathan Wolfman, you know, me and him brother was very good friend, Robbie, you know. So, just to name a few, we used to know Charlie Chaplin. They used to come from a place called Red Pond. And, yeah, just to name a few, those are some of the guys that I really used to hang out with as a youngster. Back in the days, what we used to do, we used to dance, you know. We used to dance a lot of folk song. Going to St. John's Primary, that's where I knew Santa, Lieutenant Stitchy, as they call him. So we used to do a lot of folk song. We used to dance at different places, Astor Theater. We used to dance at War Theater, Little Theater, and stuff like that. And then after that, I also used to dance at like Denby Showground. So, you know, the entertainment thing from a long time now. Long, long, long time, we're in the entertainment field. I entertain people, you hear that? Well, me used to have a voice, you know, because when I was there back home in Jamaica, me used to love to commentate horse racing, you know. Good afternoon, racing fans, and today we come to the feature event on today's race program, and it's indeed the Red Stripe Super Stake for us, rated 310s and upward. So I used to do those things. I used to commentate cricket, three slips a gully, a mid on, a mid off, a backward point. In comes Michael Olin, you know. And so I used to have a lot of friends, like when them on Saturday or on Wednesday, when race run and them miss, and them go and them miss the race, them used to come to me if they commentate about the race for them. And even cricket, football, track and field, I used to be the one that used to commentate all these things for them. So, you know, so that was one of my little passion. So me used to have the voice, and then what I used to do too, I used to DJ people's song. You know, like me used to DJ like you, Brown. I have a little girl named June, you know, and Ranking Trevor, you know, Queen Majesty. I really, really want to have a chat with you. So make we dub it with your majesty, you know, something like that. So so those are some of the guys them where, you know, them used to have U-Rai, I-Rai. I used to DJ like, you know, just impersonate those guys and used to DJ them record all the time. My parents, my mom, she got married to my sister sister's father. So that was one, and then she came here. And of course, you know, mommy now leave our kids them at Jamaica. So she work, and then she, you know, she send for all of us. So that was one of the main reasons why we migrate, just to be with mommy. No, it was a culture shock. One of the thing was, when I first got here, you know, them used to give us the impression like America is like paradise, when actually Jamaica is the real paradise. But because we are a third world country and we're poor, you know, they're hard to get work and stuff like that. So that's one of the reasons why a lot of people migrated to the United States. But when I came here, and I was in the plane, me and my brother were sitting down in the plane. I was looking out the window. And when I look out the window and we saw the lights and the cars and everything like that, I was like, wow, you know? But then the next morning when I wake up in Brooklyn, St. Mark's Avenue, Nastron and Rogers, oh gosh, man. Yeah. And then I came in the fall, almost beginning of the winter, and the cold, it was crazy. I was like, man, I want to go back home. I came here in 1979. Yeah, so a long, long time there, foreign. And today, yesterday, I see a lot of them come and I see a lot of them go. In Jamaica, well, they used to, all right, in Jamaica on the radio, they used to play not a lot of dancehall, but they used to play like a lot of, as you said, those boogie woogie kind of music and a lot of calypso, because they used to have a thing with them called Calypso Corner. So if you want to hear dancehall music, you'd have to go in a dancehall. I'm not talking about, because dancehall is not just the music. It was just where the place was, the place where these dances were kept. That's what was the dancehall. So as a local youth, we used to sneak under the fence them and go in a dancehall, itch up in the corner with the big man them, listen to the big man them conversation, and, you know, and just jam to some music, to some U-Rye, I-Rye, U-Brown, and all these, Rankin Trevor, Rankin Joe, and all these guys, you know, where you used to run the place back then. I came here in 1979, so, yeah, I went to Prospect Heights High School, one of the greatest schools in America. You hear that? Up here, we have a lot of big entertainers. So one of the guys that I met were really inspired me and motivated me the most was the great Screechy Dan, yeah? And he was one of the person who really take me up on them wings and show me the ropes and as we say, boots me, you know, because me used to call that DJ, but me never used to have no song. And Screechy Dan was one of the person who really helped me write my first song, you know, and him used to carry me go different, you know, look at corner, go DJ and them thing, because he was here a long time before me, you know. So Screechy Dan was one of the person who really was one of my first friend when I came here. There were some Panamanian guys on Union Street on Franklin, because Prospect was on Classen between and Washington over there and near Eastern Parkway. So there were some guys on Union Street, and they were playing this guy, dice game. They call it CeeLo or 7-Eleven, whatever. And I was walking by, just come from Jamaica, you know, and a tear down the fence, you know, with the bad boy walking, you understand? And then so the guy threw the dice, and when him threw the dice, my foot accidentally kicked the dice. And before me knew it, about 10 knife, you know? And then I see a little short man come out from nowhere and say, yo, yeah, yardy. And I say, yeah, man, me a yardy. And, you know, it was Screechy Dan. And him seemed back off, and everybody was put up them knife and everything like that. Because them they were dealing with me proper, you know. Them they were cut me up, dice and slice me up. And him just, and everybody, and I was like, yo, oh, this little man makes so much money, you know. And from that, me I say, yo, that brother, I want Dan, you know. So that's how we get Screechy Dan. Trevor Sparks, they came later on, because back then now, Screechy Dan was like the only DJ at the time. Them used to have a youth on them called Fenimore, and then there was some other guy. I forget his name right now. But there used to be some other DJ. A youth on him, Cleve. I forgot what his name, Cleveland Brown or something like that. But I forgot his DJ name, what them used to call him. But there was a guy that used to run the place. As a little small youth, them where I come up, we used to run the place. So Sparks and those guys, they came after. As a matter of fact, we was one of the person who really bring Trevor Sparks into the business. You understand? Because he used to, his uncle have one of the biggest record store, Superpower Records. But Sparks was, he was from England and he was very shy. And then when him start parody, you understand? And we find out same can sing. He used to have one song where we used to sing. I said, I can't leave Jah alone. That was the only song that he could have sung. So anyway, when we meet Sparks now, Sparks start parody and we start taking him to places and stuff like that. At that time, his name was Belly Move, because him the big and fat, have the big belly and everything. So, and he used to have this little style where he used to roll him belly, rubbing belly and rolling belly and them thing there. But, and then after that, the rest is history. He become a big superstar, big star. And then he used to have Daddy Pekka, when I'm a powering partner again. So it was a little crew with me, Daddy Pekka, Knight Rider. He used to go to Erasmus. He was like one of our rivals, but through the world away par from President Street, and we play soccer together and stuff like that. So, we adapt him. Knight Rider, you hear that? We adapt you. After meeting Screech Dan and we had met the rounds, the first sound that we really DJ upon was a sound with them called Ego Tone. God bless him soul. Ego again, him drop out. Yeah, and Ego was one of the youth who have the most vibes. And it was so funny because sometimes Ego, him used to have him speak at them and him sound system and everything. But sometimes when we go to his house, his mother, we used to make up a whole bag of noise. So him can't plug in his sound box them. So him used to have one of those, there's JVC big boom box. So that's what we used to DJ too. And we used to have a little mic and we used to hook it up. And we used to DJ. So we get our first practice from Ego Tone. When Ego Tone passed, we went to Earthquake. And then Earthquake now was this big, enormous sound. Flyer, Miller, Yardy, you know what I say? Yeah, and Flint, and Linden, and all these, youth were so power with me, and it was just crazy. They were like, they will keep a dance, they will plan a dance today, and keep it today, and the dance will be jam-packed. That's how powerful they were, So when we were their DJ, we were them resident DJ, and it was the baddest thing, and we used to just kill any sound. So that was a sound that I really made my name from, Earthquake, because I think one night we had a dance in New Jersey, and we were the little youth that were coming up, and because there were like a big sound, like considered like Daddy Mok, Sounds Jr., Leo Tone, Downbeat, they were the big sound. So we were considered a little sound. Although our sound were actually bigger than their sound, equipment-wise, but because we don't have the name that they have, we just have to just hold a little small thing there till when, So anyway, the dance in Jersey, that's where I really make my name. So it was Reverend Badu was DJing on the song they call Express. And that night there, oh gosh, man, here's what I practice. Yo, we did the dance, bad. The reverend get mad that night. We used to, the reverend that talk about him, Mama Lulu and him green gungo and all them things there. It didn't work because them time, as a matter of fact, that's the night where Screech Dan give me the name, the lyrics encyclopedia, because it was just crazy. Crazy lyrics. Here's what I practice, and we just put it in another night there, and Reverend Badu couldn't manage it that night there. But my bad DJ still know, because actually he was the one that put me upon a big sound for DJ after that, because he came to me and he was like, yo, you're bad. So him carry me go a Galaxy upon a sound and him, It's not General. Was it General? I think it was General or one of those other sound that was coming up. You understand? So he put me upon a big sound and I saw me get a little exposure to the New York Massive because we were DJing on small sound. But after a while, Earthquake gets so big and we start clash with a lot of sounds and stuff like that. Stereopride. Unitone was another sound from Flatbush again with it big, and you know, and it was just crazy. Pandemonium, everywhere we go, it was just crazy, crazy thing all over the place. And we just blew up like whoop, blew up like a flame, like some people just throw gasoline power, and we just blew up everywhere we go. People just start recognizing you and know we used to start after a while. We start doing a lot of college shows, like we used to go to Kingsborough College, we used to go to Stony Brook, we used to go to Sierra Cruz, Albany. We used to go to BMCC, City College, and all these schools. We used to do a lot of college shows and stuff like that. So, so people start to recognize me, and you know, crazy girls used to, the groupies them and the, you know, the paparazzi them used to follow me all over the place, and that's how we really, you know. But the feeling was good. The feeling was good, you know, to be like, you know, to be known, and people come up to you and want your autograph and take picture with you and stuff like that. So that was great. That was great, 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 great feeling. Galaxy Ballroom. So them local youngsters, you know, Galaxy was this ballroom on Utica Avenue, yeah, between Church and Linden. That's where it was. So it was one way in, one way out. So if anything goes on, oh my gosh. So Galaxy was a ballroom, and that's where all the big dances were kept. It's like a basement. So it was one way in, one way out. And if anytime you met Galaxy Ballroom, you're a star. You understand? So these DJs, you know, like Mikey Jarrett, who were the godfather for the whole away. You understand? Mikey Jarrett, respect. And I respect a man as my general. Seeing who are the godfather for the whole away. When Mikey Jarrett used to have Altanairi, used to have like Ruko, used to have Scorpio, and then Monday used to dung in the basement. Mota Massey, Gregory Knows, and all these youth used to dung in the basement, and them a DJ. A crazy thing. So when you actually go to Galaxy Ballroom, you know, you can say, okay, we made it. We are star. You understand? Because all the big sound, them Third World and all these sounds used to play down there. All right, practice for us was, we used to have a sound system and we used to cut out of school. And we used to go people house, and we used to have a thing with them called hookie party. For all you who don't know what hookie party is, we used to cut out of school. Your mother leave your house at 8 o'clock in the morning to go to work. And then hookie party starts at 10. And we have to finish by 3. Clean up the house. And then mommy come home and like nothing happened. Okay? So that was hookie party. So we used to have hookie parties. And that's where we used to get our practice. And then we used to have other, you know, we used to just play a song. And we used to write lyrics. So when we used to write lyrics, when we used to make cassette, whenever I used to want, me and Squeechy Dan was like, yo, we can't make the cassette them sound like the one in Jamaica, which was actually dances. But we never know, say, they were DJing at different sections or different parishes and different places in Jamaica. So we never want our cassette them come out with the same lyrics them pan it all the while. So we used to have to write. We constantly was writing songs. And then when we make our tapes them, our cassette them, you know, them used to have different lyrics, and people used to look at me and say, boy, them wire full of lyrics, because we never used to repeat the same lyrics them on the same cassette. Once in a while, you hear them thing there. As a matter of fact, when we were going on our first tour, which was Bermuda, outside of the United States, because we used to travel within the United States, you know. We used to do like a domestic flight then within the United States. But when we used to travel out of the United States, the first time we ever traveled out of the United States was on the power of those same cassettes that we used to make in the basement. As they say, practice make perfect. You see? So therefore, when these guys, that's one of the things, that's one of the treasures of dancehall back in the days, because we practice a lot. going to the basement, and we used to do that for 5, 6, 7, 8 hours. Sometimes the whole night, we used to do that there practice. You understand? So these young kids nowadays, them just make up a beat, and they just go and them sing. So that's one of the things. Them can't even perform. Because when we used to perform, when we used to be in the basement, it was like actually a dance. It was like a stage show. You understand? We have an audience, and they were like, you know, watching us and cheering and booing at the same time. You understand what I'm saying? So we have that under our belt. So when we actually go on a stage, it was just crazy. You understand? That's what they're missing. A lot of them, they're just, we call them studio DJ. Them just can't DJ in the studio, but to actually perform, they can't do that. Most of the song that these current artists are doing right now, they're actually records. The one them what we used to do back in the days, they weren't records. They were just practice song, and then that's how you record them, by the response that you get from the audience where you perform for. You understand? So if you perform a song and it's not too hot and nobody in the ray and Ray feel the song, you might not even record that song. But if someone is screaming for the song and you say, yeah, everybody's, you know, your friend of my boots, yo, that song, the bad my youth, you know? Then that's when, you know, you say your producer will come and say, yo, record that song, they're bad. We love the response. You understand? But these guys, actually, most of their songs that they perform nowadays are actually records. Because it was like, and then again, we used to have a lot of on-the-spot lyrics. So we used to just, like me or Gullibop with the freestyle thing. We were freestyle king back in the days. Because even my first record that I make, it was actually a freestyle, you know? Computer Burial. This is the Computer Burial, the track that my friend Tony Landon, respect Landon, and I respect our man as my general. Seeing him make a track, and when he make the track, it was from that Burial, ta-da, you know, that Burial rhythm, the original studio one Burial rhythm, and he makes and him computerize it and give it the little boogie mix, you know, toop, 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 toop. And then that's how I came with that song. And I went in the song to the studio, Barclay Studio, in a new lots. Akati as a producer, crazy thing, one take, just going there. It was just freestyle. And when we're ready to do the song, the man them said, the song done already. And I was like, I'm not doing the song yet. Them say, yeah, the song done already, man. And it come out, and it was a big hit in the tri-state, and plus other states and small islands and stuff like that. Right after that, you know, it's not like nowadays when them artists are record every week, you know? So maybe after 3 months after, you know, and then Akati wasn't a producer. He was doing his 9-to-5. So his household money that he used to use to produce us. So we have to give him some time for save some more money before him can put out a next song. So that song came up maybe 5-6 months after that Ragamuffin Wine came up, you know. And then after me the Ragamuffin Wine, you have a whole heap of Ragamuffin, cause the one when them call it Flighty and Mighty, them come with Ragamuffin, love come giving the Raga life, you know. And then after that Sluggy come with rough wine, girl give me the rough wine. So I want to know, so we are teacher. Boy, yeah. We teach some people, you know, remember that, yeah? All right. Star Tour now. So, I get to Star Tour. Earthquake, the owner of Earthquake, he had to go away for a while. And that's all the whole, because Earthquake did ready for run the place, you know. May I tell you, you know, flyer, respect my general. Seeing, it did ready for run the place, but due to certain circumstances, he had to go away for a while. So after Flyer went away for a while, we never have no more bass. So Candyman, my general again, Candyman was the one we keep on singing our ears. Yo, we have a sound of a new lots there. We're bad, blah, blah, blah. So him keep on a come around there. We have a sound. So one day, me and Screech Dan went over there. And from the first time we go over there, I mean, I tell them, we hear the sound player, I say, no, sir, that sound is sweet. That sound is bad. Akati, long time Akati in the business, you know, Akati well want a crew like we. Well, him used to have Gregory Nose, And Casey Jackie was one of the Star Tone DJ. Even before us, Casey was a little kid. And him used to have Bobo General from Minimart was Star Tone before Bobo, you know. So Minimart appear Minimart now have no original DJ, you know, because Corridan, even Corridan is not really Minimart DJ. I think Sleepy Wonder the only Minimart DJ. You understand? And Sleepy Wonder is a DJ for the Third World too. So but anyway, I'm a friend them, you know, so my eyes are dry yard on them, so we're good. But anyway, we went to Star Tone, man, and Star Tone sweet. I was like, yo, that sound your bad. I can't know him thing and know him music, you know. So we just start DJ it on it and we come a killer sound. We start turn over everywhere we go, man. People used to free that way. Me not tell no lie. Me not hide and talk. Big DJ, all of the big DJ them, the small DJ them, everybody used to free that way. Squeechy Dan, Black Amsha, Skinny Man, seen Candy Man, Little Dave, Dango, Django Trilla, Trevor Sparks, 006. A crazy something, man. We used to have them. We used to do the place bad. And some other little youth, Private Pompey and them youth, they used to come around with two and them thing there. You understand? Yeah, man. Junior Rider and them youth, they used to forward around with two. But a crazy thing, man. We used to do the place bad. Okay. DJ used to say we run. Yo, let me tell you something. First of all, the first time when I met Daddy Rusty and those guys, they were like very impressed with us. Just as we were impressed with them. Because when we hear about Saxon, Daddy Levi, Papa Levi, and Tipper Irie, and Daddy Rusty, and all these other guys, we were very impressed with them. So when them actually meet us, they were very impressed with us as well, you know. But For them style kind of different from our style, because them depend on the speed rapping thing. Me young when I hold on the mic and them thing there. But when we attack lyrics and now, so we're not normal and we're not afraid of nobody neither. We used to take a whole heap of show from them big artists. Me not afraid for talk. A whole heap of big artists me used to DJ with out of town. When you go out of town, you know, the playing field level. You understand? Remember one night me there, Chicago me there, and them have Early B the Doctor, the great Early B. I'm Pupa San, a DJ upon one sound. I don't remember what name still, but a specialist who used to manage Shabba and Quabra and these guys. Yeah, for them sound up at Chicago. And me a DJ upon one sound named Talas. I went Early B. And me DJ before, and Early B used to have a song with name One Wheel Wheelie. We have a wheelie, One Wheel. And me go up there first before Early B. And a theme style still in the car. The Doctor, rest in peace. And me I tell you, say, same time I say, Two wheels spinning back, tires chipping. This is not a joke, I don't want you to grin. Believe it or not, this is a serious thing. Me I go ride through Bronx, Manhattan, Queens, and Brooklyn. Cyclists, say it to pandemonium. Yo, a crazy thing in the man. Place done. When Early B DJ One Wheel really, yo, them I ask, say, wait, I'm a pirate, are you there? That's how it was, yeah. You know? When it was actually his style. Oh, Shaggy them. Oh, all right, Shaggy. Shaggy, I saw you on Soundchat and you were saying Soundchat with Irish and China, you were saying that you don't say something still, but you know, you never really say what you want to say, but me gonna say it for you if you want to say. Well Shaggy, I will spank them properly. Yeah man, Shaggy them get the spanking tonight there. Shaggy bad DJ still, you know. Because we were older than Shaggy them, so when them did that come up, them used to look up to us as some look as a general, you understand? But them bad still, Red Fox, Shaggy them. Raven used to power with me, because Raven a vital youth. Raven, make the man them know say a President Street you come from. So anyway, Shaggy now, which is Mr. Bombastic for all those who don't know, and or Carolina, and It Wasn't Me and all these other songs. It Wasn't Me, yeah, that's Shaggy. So anyway, we had a clash one night, and we were hired guns because we don't really DJ upon Sounds Junior, but them hire we, and them say, sure, we have some youth up, so we go like, so them bad, so we have to go assassinate them. So it was me and Screech that them put up, and May I tell you, Shaggy, they up there, they talk him thing, you know, but in time we hold that, you know, spank that properly, you know, because one lyrics me take, you know, me not even the DJ or nothing, but just one lyrics me take, and me say, I have this dog, we live down the lane, and Shaggy was his name, S-H-A-G-G-Y, 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 and Shaggy was his name, Shaggy, him and me dog in my yard, her Shaggy, him and me dog in my, now me have this dog, and them call him Shaggy, and I trouble, oh gosh, man, about 100 times they pull up that, and that saw me, I tell you. And Shaggy, that was the last time I saw Shaggy anyway. I don't know if Shaggy, them put Shaggy in a pound or what them put him, but I joke, I make Shaggy go start make a whole heap of pounds. So. Yeah, that's that, but him still the road. Yeah, definitely. When an artist, cause me get killed before, Mikey Jarrett, and I use them called Daddy Mills, I can't forget him. In a Flatbush one night. But just run up now and dance. There was a sound clash. I wasn't in the clash, but two of my friends them up on the sound. And I see them I get slaughtered. I go help them out. And go help them. Try help them the wrong time. Because, you know, the wrong set of crowd. Because, you know, and the youth and him Daddy Mills angle me bad. And then one night again, it was me, Admiral Bailey, was in a club in Queens. I think it was Barney from Stone Love. He had a dance in a Queens. It was me, Admiral, and my friend Louis Rankin. Yo, Louis Rankin. Teddy Brookshot. Axe. You know, from Belly and from Shatters. I'm a friend. Yeah, they had a dance that night, and yeah, Mikey Jarrett up there, and me I go on wicked at the dance, you know. Mikey Jarrett come there, come say two things, and you know, say me one clash artist, because we not play with nobody in time, we hold them. So me and him start go at it. But he was just talking, and I was DJing, but him get the better of me that night there. So Mikey Jarrett, yo, me still have you up. When me hold you, you're an old man now, so yo, watch it. We clash with a whole person, you know, Steropride, Minimart, oh gosh, man, Minimart. That was the clash. Everybody that waited for that clash there. But my friend them, Bubba, Sleepy, Corridan, me not in a lie. But I never want a clash there still though. KC Jackie, me know she never want a clash there. Because I couldn't angle it. You hear that? I couldn't angle it. Me I tell you. Me say. But unfortunately, the dance end prematurely because of circumstances behind our control. Sleepy one, you hear that? You have a general still, and you go a good. Big up Sleepy one from Thievery, because I will look at general that. And we have a big up Pac-Man too, you know, Marshall one, Corporal Tan, Fly the one that, Jerry Dan, them you there, we soldier them, so big up on yourself. It was Eruption versus Minimart, you know, but back then, me and Minimart, we were like enemies, you understand? But then, me and them come, so them say, you can't beat them, so them come join me. So Minimart can't beat you, know, so them come, so we come join. So as a matter of fact, we start to DJ upon Minimart, like when them have dances and stuff like that. So the dance we are talking about, you know, with Eruption. I was on Eruption, but me and them was friends, so me never really want angle them and call no name, because I'm a friend them, I'm going to see them tomorrow, so me can't call up them name and them thing there. And some of my friends, them can't take, them not supposed to belong in a clash either, so, because they will fight. I would never want the good dance mashup still, but that was a good dance, you know, we enjoy ourselves still, you know, good dance, yeah. First artist from New York for perform Pan Sting, that was Sting 1989, Sting 89. Yeah, Jamaica, the National Stadium, remember, 60,000 people, yeah. So how I got on that show was, I did, when I, it was Specialist, so I went to Chicago the second time, and there was a clash, Pioneer, and versus All-Star, and me I tell you, it was me, and again, San and some, and me I tell you, me and San was there going at it. In Chicago, and so the night when Specialist hear me, he was like, yo, my youth, I never know what I saw your bad, but that time now I started taking up Naki under my wing. So Specialist was the one who used to produce, was Shabba's manager and producer, Mike Cabra, and also Patra. So him hear me now, and him I say, yo, my youth, yeah, man, you have to come and sting, you know. And then, so when we was in New York, there was a English DJ, Caucasian DJ. His name is Dominic. He's from England. And then they have a kid named Clement Irie. He's also from Jamaica. Bad artist, them. So, and very popular, well-known artist all over the world. And so we had a dance at the Underground. And it was supposed to be a friendly thing. But afterward, you know, egos start to clash. And it turned out into a clash. You understand? So people's feelings got hurt. So them say, and some big producer was in there, so them say they're going to have For the Hard Way clash in Jamaica. And so that's how we actually got to sting, you know. But before that, still, me have I used to write for this Japanese magazine. From this company named Takian, and they used to do a reggae magazine. So I used to write for them, and also Naki, which was introduced to me by Mikey Jarrett. He took me over there, and they were doing a Christmas album or something like that, and they wanted a song from me. So I did the song, and then after that, Naki, he keeps calling me because him feel comfortable talking to me and stuff like that. I was talking to him for a while. Then after that, now is like Naki moving with me, because everywhere I'm there, it was my everywhere that I go, Naki was there. And then we start teaching the culture, the way to talk and everything like that. And then I start writing for him, and we used to write some songs. So one of the first songs that we actually wrote was a big song that went platinum in Japan, a song named Combination. And it was just a little fun song. We were just playing around and, you know, and just hanging out. And and it goes like, combination, combination, James Bond and Naki, I go talk like one. My name Naki, I come from Japan. My name James Bond, me a Jamaican, but watch out. Anyway, we pass through session of a ram, me say, come Pupa Naki, sing a Japanese song. Go shimoko na punete. But Naki, respect to the eye still, but enough time, and me should I go upon him. So more, when you had your tour, you used to make Jerry Harris and some other people DJ my song, and I never used to get no credit for it. I never used to love that still. That's why me and you not do no more tune. And that's why, and as a matter of fact, the album, the first album that Naki did, I like most of the songs on that album, I wrote everything, and I never get credit or get paid for it. So, you know, them things, they kind of hurt me. So that's why more time, I not even deal with certain people no more. Yeah, because I write all these songs, publishing and all these things. And if it wasn't for me, look at my friend Jerry Harris, him teach me the thing and just say, yo, yeah, you have to get some money, you know, because the song was big in Japan. Everywhere, it was like an anthem in Japan. When I went there the first time to Tokyo and then to Osaka, Kagoshima, and all these other places, stadium, mini stadium was jam-packed. People were singing the song like a church. Them, they're like, it was a church song, like a choir. You know what I'm saying? And me never get no royalties feet or anything like that. So I'm vexed for that, Naki. God know. But yeah, I'm a virgin still, because I'm all right. Yeah, I'm good. All right. I tell the truth. Yeah, man, I used to write a whole lot of song. Yeah, for some people. People used to ask me, even if I don't write the songs for them, may have input on the song, you know, input in the song, you know. Me and Bobo General was one of them. We write song together, I have input in some of them song them and stuff like that. You know, all of my little friend them used to pardon me, because right now, true, I'm not active in the business right now, so all of my lyrics them, I'm a friend them DJ it for me, you understand? In the 90s, me did kind of lose the love, because when I was singing, you know, whenever I used to make no money, you know, but we used to have the love of the music. So we used to do it for the love. You understand? So I lost the love of the music. And one of the reasons why I wasn't around, because of the producers, them, even the radio personnel, the radio personalities, them never used to treat the New York artists, and we never used to get the respect where we, you know, where that we deserve. You understand? Because enough time dance I keep, you know, and some man go like so, and keep some dance, and artists from Jamaica no show up, and I wheel them lean pan. You understand? For people no mash up them dance and fling stone and fire shot on them dance because the entertainer from Jamaica used to take their money. But when them have them big show I keep and the entertainer from Jamaica when I get no respect, them just kick it to the curve like some look at what this girl and that me never like with no for them. We don't have a call on name still no, but them never used to go. No. Gil Bailey, respect to you, sir, cause Mr. Bailey used to keep up here with song them. For we, Mr. Gil Bailey. Honor, respect, and manners. You used to play with song them, and when you keep your dance, you used to put it on your flyer, and we used to get paid too. We never used to make a lot of money, but we used to get paid. Respect to a sound from Philadelphia, where me and Mr. Easy, Miss Linda, World of Girls, used to DJ upon Shadows. Yo, Shadow International, respect. Them mute the Black Mirror, and them mute, they crowned me for New York, the King of New York. So, respect to them mute, they still hear that. If me still miss it, yes, sometimes I do, when I go to, like when I see some youth, a DJ, and, you know, and when I have the fire, like, you know, when I go stage show, I see some youth, a DJ. Enough time when I go to Berry show, I go to Bujo Bantan, well, Bujo, they are jail now, but anytime I go to Jamaica or anywhere, I see some music I play, I still get the fire in me, because I know I still have it, because enough time to me run up on them and just deal with it wicked, and just come off and just leave them, you know, wanting some more, but... Yeah, I still get, you know, I still have the fire, you know. I still feel like I can do it. Mikey Jarrett, well, me call Mikey Jarrett Mr. Atlas because of him carry this on him shoulder. Yeah, the great Mikey Jarrett, OM, you understand? Out of merit, you understand? Yeah, man. You may say, out of OD, out of distinction, Mikey Jarrett. Him carried upon him shoulder for all these years. Enough man that help him carry it, you know, because you have, you know, some local elders, but them always drop off. But Mikey Jarrett still night. And, you know, as a matter of fact, I was watching TV the other day and I saw, what's her name? Nicki Minaj, ex boyfriend, what's his name? Safari. And he actually did over Mikey Jarrett's song. And he was talking about Stunt Daddy, Stunt Daddy, Stunt Daddy, Stunt Daddy. And Mikey Jarrett did the song, Mark Daddy. Say, Mark Daddy, Mark Daddy, Mark Daddy. So Mikey Jarrett, are you named Atlas? Are you carry New York on your shoulder all by yourself? Respect. Respect to Don Beato and them, because our next general that. He might play the thing and Mikey Jarrett a DJ the thing. So respect to them youth there. The man if you get credit, the man if you have one little column put up with them thing. Because I him carry it. So Mikey Jarrett, I had the whole of a godfather. You understand? And great grandfather and all them something there. And great, great, great grand too. Altanairi, Mota Massey. Yeah man, Altanairi. Actually they say that Altanairi was the one that actually invented the speed rap. Me don't know, but I that them say. So me go with it. Altanairi, him are the first person me actually hear with it before me hear the English shoot them with it. You understand what I say? So, but Altanairi was a great DJ. Only thing him used to get drunk too much, but God bless him soul, because I'm not there. You understand? We're not talk bad about him, but a good youth, good DJ when he's sober, but and him used to rock the dance. Reverend Badu and them generally, them used to rock it. I used to go watch them, and because they were my peers, and them used to just look up to as a DJ, you know, at them man they screech down, I'm a greatest motivator, inspiration, but me used to look up on them, them inspire me, because when me used to see them, I do. So some people, when you ask them, who inspire them, them look on you and say, Bob Marley, and them say this and that, and Rary and this one, when it's actually the people them we are watch every day, and them inspire you, like screech down, Mikey Jarrett, Reverend Badu and all these youth, all these guys, when I was coming up, Mota Massey, Gregor Knows, those are the guys that I see. And the sound man, them Kanai, you understand, Naya Tone and them sound there, you understand? Those are the sound I'm used to listen to and them inspire me if you do what me I do. Papa Tayan, was a great guy, and was a good friend too. And as a man where used to encourage me, you know, me used to see him. I think when he left New York, I saw him in Boston a couple of times. Me and him did some show up there, and him inspired me too. And him used to motivate me, and used to encourage me as an elder still, but you know them get the recognition before me. You understand? So it was a great, but them time there, it was just punchline. It wasn't the bag of lyrics. That's why when Saxon, old Third World, I'm dealing with them proper, because they had a whole bunch of lyrics, and punchline never did that work them days. The only DJ from Jamaica where used to inspire me a lot was also Nicodemus, God bless him soul, Johnny Ringo, God bless him soul. You understand? Yeah. I don't know, but most of the DJ them will happen. And most men nowadays, back then, them bleach, and them never used to go to doctor, them not take care of themselves. So you see the little thing with them called regular checkup. Most of them never do it. Them just had them smoke, drink, and them never used to go to the doctor, go take time out for go check on themselves. Until that's why you see cancer, them diabetes and all these things, a lot of them could have actually saved themselves. A lot of times when them have certain things and they were going through their things and people had talked to them, them never want to listen, because I guess they think they were invincible and no, nothing, you know, it's going to go away. You understand? When actually, if you don't take care of it, it's not going to still there. You understand? So maybe that, I think that's what contribute to those, them health problem with them have. Because them never used to check up and go to the doctor, and and them a smoke, them a drink, them a bleach, you know, and them body just get run down. Because if you don't take care of this, you know, your body, you know, it don't, you know, although I kind of have a little belly right now still, but it come with age, yeah? It come with age. To be honest with you, I'm not around, I'm not active in the dance hall as I used to be before. So, you know, most of the things them when me see is either on YouTube or my friend them tell me. So I don't really know. So if you ask me who are on New York right now, I don't even know. I don't know most of the artists them in New York right now, because I'm not in the streets like that anymore. I'm hardworking. I have my blinds thing around. So if you want some blinds, remember, call me. See? And then I work for one of the best companies in the whole world. Ferrero, we make chocolate, Rocher, Nutella, and stuff like that. Tic Tac, that's the company I work for. So, I'm gonna check it out. Some people have them dream, you understand? And I'll tell them that it's good to dream, but at the same time, every dream have to have a reality. You understand what I'm saying? So, if you reach certain age and you see, when you have family to take care of and them things, especially New York artists, when you have family and to take care of and stuff like that, and you're still sitting. And then again, music, you never know, because I see those guys that did the song, Macarena, they were in their 60s when they got a hit. So, you know, music not have no boundary, and you can never tell when you get a hit. So, if I a dream and that's what you want, you have to just get 100% and stay with it. You understand? Because you never know what might happen. But for me personally, the struggle is real. And the struggle, I do my struggle already in the music thing. And I decide, say, I can't bother with the struggle anymore. There's other things that I could do. And that's the reason why I took myself away from it and take with myself and, you know, and do something else. I still love music, I still listen to it, and I still can DJ, but, you know, it's not for me. I lose the love of the music for a long time ago.
But you're doing pretty good for yourself now, right?
Yeah, I'm all right. I'm good, you know. Yeah, family youth and everything like that. So, you know, I'm good still, you know, everything good. Yeah, I want to say what's up to the whole of New York, all of my fans, them from back then, and my fans, them now. You understand? Want for big up, you know, vital, because them there's some learn everything. No matter what I go on, vital was like a university. You know what I say? I have to big up, you know, again, rest in peace, Principal Yabby, Ines, you understand? All of the vital soldier them. Yo, Daddy Pekka, Knight Rider, you understand? Yeah, Junta, don't worry yourself, my brother. Easy. Yo, Flower, yo, we have a big up, Yashua, that are Everton, Edwards, Flipper T, you know, Steve, Ras E, you know, down in Jamaica, you know, soldier them that, you know, and all of the youth them from half of the corner, because you don't know too much name. So, you know, Stepper, yo, Bobby, don't worry yourself, because you don't know, I see you up on Facebook regular, you hear that. All of the soldier them, Colin, yo, Colin Force, them youth, they used to play a record and them thing there, seeing, and all of the youth them, the girl them from the corner, Jai and Jasmine and Kosi and Ingrid and Anna and all of the little girl them from half of President Street. We have big woman now, have them kids and a grandmother, some of them. Yo, just big up, you know, because other black they make with all the way. So we have a vital for life. Hear that? President Street, yeah, Nastran and Rogers. That's how we cut, that's how we think set, and that's how we neighbor string cut. You understand? Respect, Anna. Respect and manners, hear that? Boom shot.